This is Andrew with iSpy. We're down here at the Local Motors booth in the ETC. Gonna take a behind the scenes look at what's going on. Come on. Where did the design for this car come from?
Sure. So everything with Local Motors starts from the community. We have a community of designers, engineers, fabricators, and enthusiasts that we leverage and work with every time that we do a development. We're really about including that community in the efforts that we do because it really adds a richer input of creativity than we could get just from an internal team. So in the case of the 3D printed car, we ran a challenge around the technology. So we came to the community and said, hey, we've got these partners in Oak Ridge National Labs in Cincinnati that we're working with that have this technology for large scale additive, and then also making a hybrid development with it with subtractive, as we're doing with the Thermwood machine. We created a design brief around what the restrictions for that tech were, and then presented it to them and challenged them to see what they could do conceptually with it around the limitations that we had set. And the Strati was the result of that.
Now that we got to see how the design came together, let's figure out a little bit more of actually what this car is made of. I'm here with James. Tell us a little bit more about kind of really what this car is made out of here.
Certainly. So most vehicles are made out of a steel frame or something along that lines. What we're doing is very different. We're actually making the structure of our vehicle out of plastic. If you'll look over here, what we're using is a carbon fiber reinforced polymer. It's ABS. You may recognize ABS because it's really common around your household. Legos are made out of ABS. What we're using is, by using a carbon fiber composite, we can make it a lot stronger than most ABS, and it makes the structure of the car a lot stronger. So these are the raw pellets that we start off with, and then we turn it into that large bead extrusion there, which is what forms the vehicle.
Very, very cool. So this 3D printed car is pretty much Legos in a whole new way.
Pretty much.
That's really cool. Now, the wheels have got to be different. You can't make wheels out of plastic. What's going to really connect us to the road here?
Yeah, we didn't print the wheels out of plastic, but what we can do is use a different type of 3D printing, a different type of additive manufacturing to make the wheels. What we did was we used a machine from X1. It's a binder jet sort of process where they printed a cast mold of the wheel in sand, and then they filled the mold with aluminum and cast these wheels for us out of aluminum.
Now we're here with Jay, co-founder and CEO of Local Motors. We got a chance to see how we got the design of this car, what it's made out of, and what it takes to put it together. But what does this really mean for production, and really how this is going to change things?
Andrew, it is so exciting to see the way that we are shrinking the gap in the industry between the realization of a product and the idea that it came from ahead of time. Today, for the last 100 years in our industry, let's call it the automotive or the large, complex cyber mechanical device industries, we've taken ideas and it's taken us 5 to 7 years to move them through to completion. But as we've caught up with the internet in the last 20 years, consumer desires are changing so fast. The microelectronics industries, the apparel industries, they have caught up because the devices are simpler. They're easier to make. The parts are smaller, easier to inspect. Today, when we're making these large devices, they haven't caught up as much. It still takes us a long time. What you see here today is a glimmer, a glimpse, a real window into how that gap is shrinking really fast.
This has been another edition of iSpy with Andrew. Make sure you use the hashtag iSpyAndrew to show me all the cool and exciting things you see on the show floor. Thanks for watching.